The Reverend George Hargreaves is a man of many talents. He's been dubbed the pop pastor, for he was a producer and writer of such hits as Sinitta's So Macho back in the 80s. He works at two churches in Hackney and Poplar, and is the Faith Communities Project Manager of Waltham Forest Council. I asked him, first of all, what this role entailed.
Well, that entails working first and foremost with the faith communities so that there are better relations in terms of working and understanding amongst the diverse communities of faith that are in Waltham Forest. The next circle is a wider community so that there's understanding between the wider community of those of no faith at all and what goes on in the faith communities. And then with the council, so that faith communities can work within the strategic agendas of the council, can even steer the strategic agendas of the council.
And why is it important to have a link between different faith groups?
Well, a faith group by its very nature has a set of beliefs and values that, because it's a separate faith group, are obviously different from the one down the road. And where there are different strongly held beliefs, there's potential for discord.
Do you think there is harmony in Waltham Forest amongst the different sectors of the community?
I think there's a great deal of harmony. It's really been refreshing. We took a tour of 40-plus young people around to the various faith community places of worship. Well, one from each community. So we had a Hindu temple, a Jewish synagogue, a Sikh Gurdwara, a mosque and a Christian church. And we did that all in one day. And all the leaders that we met on that day were so happy to see the community, the diverse community, being in their place of worship, and they welcomed us with open arms. And I think that's indicative of the sort of harmony that we have in Waltham Forest, and that I can build on with the agendas that I want to push forward.
Now, you're an educated man, you've got degrees in theology and anthropology. Now, first of all, what's theology?
Well, theology is the study of God, or what people think about God. People have various ideas of what Christianity is about, what the Bible is actually saying, and through the ages, as a minister, it's good to know what people have thought.
What's anthropology?
Well, if theology is a study of God, anthropology is a study of man. One looks at the way that man has lived together, what kind of common traits are basic to man and the way that man lives. So you might talk in terms of rites of passage. In an African tribe, a youth ordeal that has to go through at a certain age, whereas in the West, it might be going through rap culture or something.
So you think popular culture is part of a rite of passage?
I do. I was at a conference with the Federation of Black Housing Associations where we were talking about building soundproof apartments for young people. And I said this was a very obvious thing to do. If kids are into music, they play music not because they're evil, not because they're their enemy, but because they like to play loud music. And if we can, why not build homes that accommodate young people in that way? It's not rocket science, it's just, you know, acoustic engineering.
What an excellent idea. Now, you've been involved in pop music yourself. You were a pop producer in the 80s and you wrote hits such as Sinitta's So Macho. How did you get into that line of business?
I started when I was at school. I got my first recording deal 30 years ago, 1974. 17 years old, and we were into Motown and the Jackson 5, and we wanted to be Britain's answer to the Jackson 5. Just as a 17-year-old today wants to be Britain's answer to, you know, whoever it is out there. We formed our band at school and set a goal of getting a recording contract, and we did. And after being in a band, I then became a professional songwriter with Motown. And from being a songwriter, learned studio craft and became a producer and wrote, as you say, for people like Sinitta, Five Star, Loose Ends, mezzoforte, as well as the BBC for a couple of TV shows as well.
And did faith play a part in any way with your pop career?
It did. There was a tension. If you listen to the lyrics of So Macho, it's hardly Negro spiritual. I remember that was a hit whilst I was at a church in Notting Hill Gate called Kensington Temple. And at that church, there were people like David and Cary Grant, guys from the group Imagination, lots of music people there. And I think for a lot of us, we really, you know, some of the stuff that we are writing about in songs didn't really fit comfortably into our faith walk. And I actually took a decision to actually focus my attention on my faith. So yes, there has been an impact, and in recent years I've spent more time writing gospel and spiritual songs than I have pop songs.
So you still write songs?
Not a lot. Mainly when my wife asks me to write something new, because she's a great singer.
Now, the Faith Communities Project, you've got a new website. Tell us about your new website.
Well, the faithcommunities.org.uk website is really what it says on the tin. It's a website for the faith communities. Now, whilst at this early stage, I'm writing most of the articles, or all of them at the moment, we're looking for, down the line, within the next few weeks and months, contributions from all the faith communities, telling us what they're doing, what they're celebrating, telling us about themselves, so that anybody who wants to know about the faith communities in Waltham Forest, say, oh, what do the Sikhs do? Go to faithcommunities.org.uk, and they get press the button that says Sikhs, and they will learn where they can worship, how they worship, why they worship, something of their history, and these kind of things. And so it's a resource for the community, about the faith community, built by the faith communities.